Good morning, guys. Welcome back to another Model Rally slash. Excuse me. Slash. Scenery video this morning. I've got both of my batteries fully charged up, so hopefully I'm going to do a slightly little bit longer video this morning. Not by a lot. By maybe 5 or 10 minutes, a little bit longer to what I've usually been doing. Because I want to cover some scenery bits today, so. I'm going to start off with running trains as normal, and then halfway through I'm going to start putting some scenery in. Yeah, it's going to be a little bit messy, but I'm going to try my best to make it not too messy for the video, but it's going to be a little bit complex to do this, but it should be interesting to say the least, or I might change the track a little bit during this video, I don't know. We'll see how the time goes. You guys all doing well? Happy 1st of March, everyone. I nearly forgot. But yeah, we are nearing spring, pretty summertime times again soon. And I'm sure you'll be proud about that. It means we're going to get depressed and dark time pretty early in the year for a while. At least until the September, October time, so we've got a fair while.
But, yeah.
Nearly summertime. Got quite a few house lines to visit this year, so I'm going to be doing that next month. And I've got the Flying Scotsman coming down the end of next month, so that'd be quite cool. Looking forward to see that. Going down to Exeter St David's next month to see the Flying Scotsman coming from going through London, Paddington, through Bristol, and then down to Exeter St David's, and then going down to, not that I think it's going to, but could be going right down to the end, I don't know. You can all guess what train is going to come up first. Yeah. It's going to be the Flying Scotsman coming up first. It'll be the Class 43 in the intercity, not the intercity livery, in the GNR livery. We're running up first. That's what he says. But yeah, I tend to run most on the start to start with because my RAM section with my whole layout. If you wanted to, you can move very fast, but I don't tend to like that that much. Just a little warm up while I'm getting in the head out of the body. Then we're going to one of the carriages on. We've got a first class on. Didn't have a standard open car, so I just wanted to put that in the middle. I'm going to pull that connection right in the middle. And then we've got a train car at back of the unit, like normal. You'll see that on real trains too, real thing. I'll speed up a little bit too, just a little bit more warm up. And then let everyone around for a bit. And then what I'll do once we've got a needle form over. I'll just keep out the camera away for the most part, as much as possible. I might be able to count quite anything here, but I don't know. No train seems to run a little bit faster. Of course they are, depending on the train. In a few minutes I'll move the tripod off the tripod and we'll get some better shots of these trains going around. She's cutting short circuits because of the engine design. She's got a little on flywheel, and I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to clean this thing, but it needs a bit of a clean, so I might take a little bit of metal frame off, vaporize, and then clean the motor. I have cleaned this motor a few times, but it is filled up so much gunk and flying and everything. Eventually need a little touch of oil. But yeah. Not doing too badly otherwise, it is a bit. Maybe a bit of good service, and I haven't done that in a couple of months. I've done this thing before autumn past year, so yeah. Well, look at summer. I can't remember. I knew it was around after sometime. I was standing there before I went down here last year, but I couldn't remember when entirely, but yeah. And then we'll kind of keep that actually, we'll do it. Okay. But, you know, the paint side, I'm going to give this a little bit of a clean. I'm not going to use any wash on the wheels. So we're going to stick on the rails, and I don't want to do that. And get all the grime off the engine. it should work perfectly well. I hope it's dried off all the excess oil. Maybe it'll work fine now. No, she's still struggling. She's trying to go, but most of it is a little bit old and not as reliable as claimed. And you've got these 51-5 in the master, which is running a lot smoother and more frequently compared to the 21 that has got a long time. But I'm going to put a drop or two of oil right inside this, and I'm going to give this window and frame a wash. And it shows it's going to run well. When you've got clean window frames, they tend to be a little bit more, I don't know the right word for it, but it's a little bit more. The train is a little bit more prone to having issues, and it's sparked back up again, so it's been a world of clean. I'm going to give a touch of oil around the driving area, but otherwise that engine rods are fine. I'm just going to fix that. going to go and do a test in this year. So I'm going to go and watch it for last year. She's basically fine. It's nice right now. I'll pick and do it with this pipe tank because there's a great number of things you can go through water. It's a bit easier for it, but not heavy. Just a little bit, so it's easy to do it. But yeah, she's done it and that's pretty good. Yeah, so my next part will be my companion dog. I'm going to get a couple more I slowed down a little bit, but something a little quick train. Didn't go well, but you know, as I said, I'm keeping the outside line going for now. I want to put the side in there a little bit, but I don't know where I'm going to do it. I'm wanting to be definitely over this one a bit more. It frees up that section of the valve. One, two, three, four, like pounds of beef. And just, I don't know how I'm going to do it. But I'll think it through and see what will happen. The nice train on this short point train is, I mean this train on the outside can really go quite fast. Next time I wouldn't let it go this fast, but I'm sharing it off with another train inside the exact same model as the train that I'm ready in, so I'm trying to do it the way on occasion. But most of the time I tend to let it do this sort of speed, she's much more happy moving around like that. She's been the way that she's going around it. More people try it. Kind of a little bit smaller. Right, today I'm just going to run around and probably try and plant it around for a bit for the other ones too. So yeah, this is my play train. Oh, the battery's gone ready again. But it's fully charged. That's only 9:30. I'll be back in a second, guys. See you in a second. Apologise guys, it's the battery died. It went red very quickly after 30 minutes, but thank you. I thought I fully charged them. Yeah, but I didn't. Oh, I left the water running, didn't I? Right, I think we'll get some type of footage from the train now. We might put the light on. It's a little bit gloomy today. We might put the guys' lights on for a short time so we can get better footage of the trains. If the guys are alright with that. Should we do the single version where we get some closer shots a little bit? Close up shots later on. Then that way we can just have a bit more. Out Falls off. I need the motors and chains and cells are very expensive chains. So I'm putting the cars as well as mine on one pocket. Right, I need to move the winding right away. And a huge second hand, solid second hand. I'm going to be working on this section, so I'm going to have to run those some small amount of water and build up this tank. A little bit. I'm going to build this one up most today. then I'm going to wipe on that side of the tingling. So, whether something that you put away will be in another video, just for the paint. It's kind of like how HD has been making a different video. June 2023, which is already, but yeah, in spring, almost springtime, this guy will be coming on quick enough. Any luck? And I might put some on the inside line if I've got time. If I've got time today, I'll do some inside stuff and then just try to mount some stuff in the mirrors with water and see if it'll work. But if it doesn't, then oh well. But bear in mind that I'm not doing it for anything to make it. I'm basically sticking it down. Find those two together and then basically make them underneath this will be well, place your bangings down and then lay down well basically all of this will be laid down properly with pork and then bars and then put it all down together and then repeatedly with the pork smooth it down and you want to put the balance down, you want to tie it around, you want to put it in. But, yeah, you can't put I could probably put some gravel beside it, but it wouldn't look ideal at the moment. But yeah, she's basically going to be running around for a little bit, as she is. And we'll put the camera over later on. So we want to get close-up shots, so. Yeah, let me get some water. We'll do some singling and then we'll touch another section and get close to that. But today instead of being 12 past, it's going to be 20 past. So a little bit longer, but I think we'll get more done. I'm going to put a 2-hour video together from last year. I'm going to put that onto my channel for this year. Water in general because water supply has been so low at the moment, it's really quite mental. Fresh water is becoming less and less easy to find. And the climate keeps changing as quickly as it does. I think that less and less fresh water will be available in the future. So, I mean, diesel trains will probably still be running for a little while longer. At least, I think some of the volume might run up to at least 2024, at least, but at least quite some of them can run up to 2035 or something. But what I'm going to even do for the most part, basically doing scenery along here, I just spend time in it. It's going to be... This is only temporary, I only put it like this because sort of mark out where the stuff is going to be laying. And then the stones will probably be laid properly around this edge here. And then there'll be a point where around the back here, all around the front. So the control of the temporary is being used and the time being. Some people use other things like cardboard and things like that to stick the ceiling down. I have started doing that at one point in my time. I was doing content on this channel for nearly 8 years on this platform, for this particular channel anyway. I've been on this train channel for nearly 8 years now. And since I started the content for the YouTube train channel up, doing nearly 8 years ago, I have the style of doing quite a lot of different areas in my life, sort of in the way to doing content. Even when I was still, things I probably was, I was still making designs of how I can make the layout look perfect as possible, without it being too realistic. So, you know, I don't want to be overly realistic, but it just kind of out of sync to the rest of the layout. So I kind of have to think in terms of how I'm going to do it without it being too in the face, basically. I know people don't like too connected things in life, but this is only for teaming use, so it's not like anything else. It's not like from this news program. I'm just using this stuff for scenery, and that's all I intend to use it for, so. So they're going to be recycled, I'm going to just use it for scenery. And once I've done that, the green stuff can go on the top of it, and then put it far more realistic than what it is at the moment. I'll tell you what, the newspaper does do it, that sort of texture, colour, which, with cardboard, it doesn't give you that same texture, which is interesting to think about it. It's quite remarkable. Newspapers do eventually break down to the point of being like crushed bit of paper mache, basically. They eventually break down to that point and they weren't able to do anything with them. I'm at the train with one of my guys, if you're wondering. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to go yet. Might be this guy, but might be bombing again, I don't know. But yeah, I'm doing a lot of mostly local stuff on the Thursday at the moment because my mind's so busy. But I'm doing other things. I've got Dawlish coming out in the end of May. Yeah. So next month is April. Then we've got June and 2 months after that. And then of course I've got 2 months after that I'll be getting my real dog, my companion dog, shall we say. So yeah, look for you guys chill for that. The end of August and September, I'm going to be getting a companion dog. And that's sort of... Once I get my companion though, I can focus on saving up my other train that I want to get for this year. And hopefully by the end of summer I will need to get one or two different type of trains. Could be anything. The steam, it could be diesel, it could be electric. Well, there'll be mainly electric on this. That anyway, but it'll probably be one or two, but... Perhaps it's going to be the diesels in this whole layout. Mostly based around the fast 43s. Nothing really much out. I'm actually going to wipe on these corners first, and then and once I feel comfortable they look ready enough, I will probably go into the next corner, which will be in the inside. Past 10 is when I'm going to finish signing today, so it's going to be a little bit later, but not the end of the world. That's why I'm noticing this stuff, it's not too bad, is it? I'm just trying to get everything in. Obviously I'm going to hope, I'm hoping, to get a couple of new trains this year. I mean it's not a lot of them, but again, maybe at least two of the HST at the very least this year. For the rest of the year, then it's not. I just want to find out now, I don't know what time it is, but probably close to 10. But, yeah, I'll probably change the trains over shortly. I'm just going to try to get some more scenery done. I'm hoping just to get a little bit onto the whole layout. It's not going to get done straight away because it takes a lot of time. And all of that stuff takes patience. And I don't always have the time to do all this sort of stuff all the time. I basically only have the time what I give myself basically before I have to say like a muscle one in a period of time or maybe a week or two before the next video will come out so I'll do another similar video. It looks pretty good, it doesn't have what I'm doing already, but all I need to do is more. Everything better. Trying to think of the best angle to put the hand border so you can see some, a couple more different frames to run today. So that's the battery out at the moment, which is good. Let's check the camcorder, excuse me. Just about 10 o'clock. Yeah. It's about to go 10 o'clock and then let's go and change the angles up. So let's do some angles to start with. And then at the end of the video, I'll show you some of that as well, together. So what I am going to be adding to it. I've got at least wrapping that up on this side. I'm going to just take this thing, this little stand piece from the tripod on, so that way you guys can see more of the trains footage a bit better, if it's possible. There you go. And I'll get the camera down on the camera. Where the cat's going to be sitting in there, it's going to have some stone stuff part of it. Most likely it's going to be basically as it is. Yeah, we're trying to get some more angles here. Trying to get a good angle. I'm just trying to avoid the water. Especially that one with the camera angle. I haven't got any more trains yet, but I would like to. I really would. I think I'm forcing them up from one room. There we go. We'll do one more round with the usual HST set and then we'll pop this train over to a different train on the outside and the inside, so don't worry, we can have a mix to run around with. But yeah. Right, first up we're going to change this to the 06 and then we're going to go from that one. Two volume around and then we're going to switch on. they go off. We're going to take a whole unit off, so we're just going to basically pull some carriages, but she's not going to pull. HSD is not going to be putting her train to that. I'm putting those away, as well as the car and training girl. I'm going to get the panio out and pull some different type of wheel set. I'll put down the tank like a moment before. She's going quite fast. Well, some of it's like around 60, or she's going about 90. We only had a minimum of doing 60, or probably very heavy than 70, but anything above 60, maybe under this, but basically for what we were designing real life. In the heavy train of probably 4. Or 5 carriages. So yeah, she would have probably pulled 4 to 5 carriages probably in real life. I'll sort her out and she'll run fine again. Power car. Put me to back on the track and back on the siding for another day. I can't drive into the sidings, but if I had them try to enforce getting running out of the siding quite nice and smooth. There we go. Should be right now if I slow it down. Or not. We can find a tender one. And see if it'll go through. If the tank one goes down on the inside, fine. And you think I was bombing past that line, but yeah. But yeah, this one works smoothly on really tight radius, so if you've got a really tight radius layout, you're probably better off having like a little pug to run around for your little depot. Putting the odd wagons out. Or even a tank locomotive, because most tank locomotives can go around first or second radius curves. And of course we've got the tender one that's going about to move. So you're not going to put anything today, I tried it yesterday, but... And of course last week too. Yeah, I paid this one 20 quid for this one last year, so pretty good. Let's see it go. on my lap for the tender one. I'm going to just kind of talk a little bit through the rain that's been today. But we won't hear longer tomorrow. Or I might be in chat with you for something different, I don't know. Now tomorrow is train day. That is, it's the mainline train day tomorrow. Either train this side or Bombing Park Bay as usual, because it's pretty close by to me. But it is local to me and I've got to keep it for finance reasons, keep it local for the most part. And of course my mum is so busy. Of course that could change in the future, but obviously at the moment, obviously I've got to keep them local. Why's the pony has stopped? As we see in my baby's train tomorrow, I think they're thing that turned off that. Which is the fast way to train. But I do also have a favourite. I mean, I quite like the Voyagers, but I don't mind being a model for them, but I do like little things. They're kind of interesting looking, but as it comes to my passion train, definitely it's going to be fast way to train every time. But I just find the Voyagers are quite unique in their own way. That's not much I can say about it. It's because bizarre logo, really, that one. I mean, I never own a Voyager. Would I ever want to? I mean, I wouldn't mind him maybe in the Virgin livery or something, but I mean, take a look at it and review it, right? But would I see that? I don't know. I'm not a big fan of pictures, so I'm not a super pictures. Something about the 87 between the Tanya is that the Tanya won't do anything. Well, the 87 won't do anything to the Tanya. I mean, she can go faster if I want her to. So, if she was running late somewhere, I should go up a little bit. So, yeah. It's a nice train. There's a switch underneath on the 87 where you can only set the lights to day and night. On most trains, on most modern home trains, they don't tend to make them like that. Only a few do have that option. And I think the one benefit that I think the two would have, if they were ever going to update it, because of the new motor and a new set of switches underneath the cab, well, underneath the body, you can have a switch for day and night. So one set would be just for like the 87 set, so the two outer lights be on for day, and then you have another set for the two inner lights for the night, with the cab light switched on. So that's a possibility that they could feature in a future video on the HST, but would they do it? I don't know. I mean, it's pretty cool as it is, but the switch possibility, the possibility they could easily do something like that. It's just having the time and the patient put it all together. It'll more efficient. Yeah, but the trains are like that. They take a lot more time up. But they're usually worth it in the end. Because they do put their time into it. And of course, you know, you get locomotives are very bizarre ones, getting one person who's ready to message me a couple of weeks back, or 4 or 5 days ago, saying that Cryogenic Engine is not a javelin. It is a javelin, I've done my research, and it's Hitachi, so it is by the Japanese. So the javelin was made by a Japanese company. Hence why the models are owned by Hornby. And the diesels, some of the diesels are owned by Batman, so. But yeah, there's quite a few, you know, similarities in between them. And the housing are owned by the 58s and the 33s and a few of the 47s, but they tend to work on most of this diesel stuff over in the housing, but there might be a few schemes, I haven't looked into them to be honest. But Hornby, the best diesel they ever made is the Fast 43. For Infrared, they've done the best job of that one, but I think they could do some updated engines on them. Being that, because it is what it was from the past with their engine design, but put some upgrades with the light system, but less flimsy wires than need to be needed, but more stronger wires. So that way, when people who maintain the service their Class 43s, HST sets, any livery, it means they have a switch underneath to switch the lights on and off. And there's an alternative option for those that want to put drivers in at both ends to get swapping to one end of the unit to the other. Then you can lift the body off or have the door slightly a little bit wider to to push the driver in, and it's like getting through the cab. Brain trainers tend to drive it still going up to maybe Dublin, because the GNR did do that. Went up to Dublin and back from the East Coast, I think it was. So, yeah, I think that was the area it used to run on. And then Pendolino did the South Coast, which was really tight radius, and it did distortion going on across the country, but yeah, that was pretty cool. I went on that Pendolino a long time ago, but it was pretty awesome. So I still had this Pendolino in working action. Well, kind of. If I connected all this train together, if I let her run, without her, well, D7 being involved, and she got all her units together, then probably she would be a full runner, but I'm not doing that today. I'll probably try to get her out near the weekend, maybe. I'll try to get her running. And you'll hopefully see the, on Friday's video, I'll try to remember this afternoon to bring the platform in, and the platform house, and the ASIC part of the station house will be coming in this afternoon, so I can show you on Friday to what I've done to it, as well as the fencing to go down on the footpath where they can keep the trains from filming. And we're just going to check the time, so I don't know how much time. Spring past 10. Oh, that's all right. Okay, I'm going to end this video then, guys. I did say it would be a little bit longer video, but that didn't say like a few minutes over for that time. Right, I hope you guys have a great day. Look after yourself. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys on either a Bobbin video tomorrow, Bobbin Parkway video tomorrow, or the Scarred video tomorrow, depending on how I feel tomorrow. Hope you guys have a great day, and peace out.